quarterfinal and lost to Lin from China. And Lin will play the second semifinal against Yoshimura from Japan. So two Japanese junior boys in the final, in the semifinals, I should say. Robin Owen is last year the junior, really on that, in this very positive situation for the moment, where he is looking to break through on the international scene. He's certainly one of the French players that we will see now playing on frequent major championships, I'm sure, for his national team. Koki, such a talented player, fantastic reaction, read, and can play far from the table and close to the table as well. And he was involved in a tough quarterfinal yesterday when he beat out one of the Chinese players, Zheng Peifeng, in a 4-3 match. He was in some trouble there, Koki. Won down 2-1 and really had to dig deep, but did that in a good way. Koki at times can be perhaps too relaxed and too comfortable in his game and just relying on skill, and that won't cut it on this level. You have to work hard as well, so he knows that when he's now serving in this junior boys' first semifinal. I have to say also Quentin Robinow played very well in his quarterfinal against Liam Pitchford from England. Well, Robinow won 4-1. Looks focused and strong. Physically well prepared for these championships. And likes to get out on a good distance, Quentin Robinow, though, to use his quite powerful backhand topspin or forehand topspin. Let's see if he can find that perfect distance to work, or that Koki can find the angles perhaps to gain the advantage. Difficult to read here, although Koki Nima, with his ranking, should be the favorite. Flick over the net using a lot of speed and spin in that ball. Koki's trying to do the same, but misplayed that one, played on the edge of the racket and the ball flew out. That's what Robinow is handling. A lot of quick attacks and when he gets out on the perfect distance. Serve and a good attack by Koki. Although Quentin Robinow put a lot of spin in that ball, and Koki worked in well and was aggressive. Side spin as well. Koki Nima is a hard player to play against because his rhythm in the matches are very different. He's scoring some fantastic points and giving away some easy points and so on. So it's hard for your opponent. You really need to be focused on your own game. Close to the table, far away from the table. You don't really know where you have this left-handed Japanese. Choosing different ways of scoring points.
Oh!
powerful attack by Robinho, scoring 2 points in his own service, and obviously it's now tight here in the opening game. Yeah, for the first time going down the line with that serve and holding on a little bit under pressure, and trying to take a bit of a wrist shot from behind just to stay in that rally, but Mura, couple of good forehand toss, been really close to the table. It's hard for Robinho to get time and space to execute that backhand topspin. That was well played by Robinho, low with a lot of spin. No. And then a good serve, and Robinho does have come with a really, really good serve as well. One and then 2 points in Robinho's serve, and now Niva with the serve. Very well played by Robinho, who fought hard to play 3 topspins in a row and kept the pressure on and worked with his footwork to stay in the rally. It was a little bit there, but the ball short back. It went too far, that one there. And Niva into the table and really found a perfect angle to attack on. Very well played by Niva, well read. And then that pass starts down the line where Robinho seems to have some trouble to get his technique in order. And now suddenly under siege. Fantastic by Quentin Robinho, almost outside the table, had to work hard to keep that ball there, and that's good strength, good wrist work by Robinho, actually very well done. Niva now has to regroup, and let's see if he comes down the line again with his serve. No. Hard, and Niva not really getting his footwork in order on that one. And he has some weaknesses close to his body, I think, where he loses tempo and pace in his forehand topspin. And the first game to Quentin Robinho, who shows a fantastic will and really motivation in the end of this opening game. Semi-final, and a lot of confidence as well to come back and win the opening game 14-12. Now both these players obviously advancing to this stage of the competition, not that easy. Today Robinho opened up against Kumo from Russia 4-1, beat Dijas from Poland 4-0, relatively easy. Also played very well against Kim Dong-yoon from Korea in the match before the quarterfinal, winning 3-2, 5-6. So obviously the form is really strong for Quentin, who then yesterday, as I said, beat Liam Pitchford from England 4-1. Was playing well in that quarterfinal all the way through, really just losing a second game to Liam, and then won 9-8 and 7 to finish up with a 4-1 lead. Now Kokiniva started off winning all his 3 opening matches without losing one single game, and then had problems obviously, as I said, with Zheng Peifeng from China yesterday, where Koki had to battle hard to win 4-3. Brings to the game of table tennis a well disguised backhand topspin with very, very lot of power and a quick move. So struggling a little bit with his forehand game, I think, that it's not really consistent. Those kind of balls you have to play with a little bit more care, and he's a bit careless in his forehand attacking game at times. And now Robinhoe is in a good rhythm, really moving well, and also finding both backhand and forehand topspin solutions. Again, good challenge. So that's Nima losing a little bit of his patience and not showing a lot of movement there in the ball rotation. And Nima has to be much more active with his footwork in order to play those forehand topspins on the table. So it's Quentin Robinhoe leading 4-2. Good backhand flick by Nima. That's a better technique from Nima, who got some support from his body and really much more safe forehand than just touching it very quick. And then it's a close backhand domination, backhand block cross, and then down the line and putting pressure on Robinhoe, so we have 4-all. There's really no reason for Nima to go down to backhand with that one. You have the whole table open, basically. You can play that with different placement, maybe would be better. And then, again, fantastic backhand from Koki Nima, and that's what he will bring to a really fantastic shots. Quick backhand, good block down the line, and then a quick one cross, really no chance for Robinhoe. Service down the line well disguised. Robinhoe didn't read the direction of that serve. And then a confident side overspin half long by Nima. No chance to read that one. That was probably long, but Robinhoe missed just the length of the service and just stepped in with his racket, and then the ball just was there for the taking for Nima. Strong backhand, and there's his really strength from the behind the table, where he gets the perfect distance and then really pulling through with that backhand that came down the line. And it's excellent by Robinhoe, who's keeping the pressure on Nima. So he's of course confident after being the first game and seems to be ready to play. Overview picture, a beautiful venue here in Bahrain for these championships. A good service return by Quentin Robinhoe. 8-all. And that's the good thing with Robinhoe, he stayed in this game and kept the pressure on. Now, although Nima played some good points, Robinhoe came back, so 8-all. A really perfect situation for Quentin if he can execute in this last few points. Let's see now, 8-9. Well placed backhand down the line, so Nima with the serve, obviously, which is an advantage. He served well, better in this second game. And he still has that service down the line to use now if he's sure, perhaps we see one of the two serves coming in this direction where it's been fairly successful. But no, he was dominating the backhand game there. Perfect by Robinhoe, who's really scoring some fantastic points from behind the table there, with really his strength is. It's hard to read. He can go with plenty of options, both back and forehand, powerful. Too happy with that one, although it was well thought. And that's a low spin in the back and obviously from Robineau, but again, a little bit careless with his technique and just drove the ball off the table, off balance. And now we have an exchange of mistakes. Robineau long fast service, didn't get perfect touch on that ball. I'm sure he's disappointed with that one. So Neva with another game point. And net out. Again a bit of an error, and if Robineau wasn't happy with the last one, I'm sure Neva is not happy with that one that should be on the table. But again, try to go cross court, and I think he has to change up a little bit to be more successful. Maybe take off some of the speed and place the ball better. But that's not as well played by Koki Nina, who read that ball from Robineau very well and then just stepped in and used a placement deep in Robineau's forehand. So Japan with one game ball again. Robineau answers very, very well with a couple of quick backhands. Really learning that movement very well from using backhand over the table and protecting his backhand corner. And now Robineau with a game point to go up 2-0 lead there, which would be huge for the French junior. And again, one of these forehand techniques that doesn't fit really with Neva, who doesn't get a whole lot of body support in that forehand topspin. Just an error, really. Just standing still and not overplaying that ball all the time. You have to be better on execution, on specifically those balls. But that's not Neva's strength, really. His forehand has, he has a lot more work to do in the training hall with his coaches to get that forehand fixed. Otherwise, it's a fantastic, skillful play like that. Obviously, it's only worth 1 point as well. So he's mixing some fantastic shot with some easy misses so far. So Quentin Robineau, at least now, on his way to the final, although this seems to be a very, very closely contested match, winning with 2 points in the opening game and 2 points in the second game as well. So 2-0 for Robineau, but anything from safe. We're in the third game of the Junior Boys semi-final in the Volkswagen World Junior Table Tennis Championships here in Bahrain. And it's an interesting matchup in actually both semi-finals, where Japan has two players. Neva, as we see here, and Yoshimura will come up in the second semi-final against Lin from China. So Japan basically have two chances to get one Junior Boy in the final. I think that Neva is for sure expecting to be there as the favorite in this match, but he has to watch out because Quentin Robineau has played very well in the single competition, looks very confident to me, and really working perfectly from the distance. Although there Neva dropped one and then changed the speed on the second one. And just a drop ball, and Robineau too far away from the table couldn't find the good shot to keep himself in that rally. So Niva with a 3-1 lead. Better forehand, Nibali pounding the ball down to Robineau's backhand. And Robineau then answering with a backhand topspin into the net. Or just a block into the net. 5-1 for Niva, Robineau serving. Fast-paced, first in the final, these boys don't waste a whole lot of time. But service and then full blast on the ball, although Niva tried to just lift that, losing his concentration a little bit. Now 5-4. Oh, fantastic backhand shot by Quentin Robineau. Really, really amazing shot. He's just stretching out there. And, oh, look at that one. One of those circus shots. That still is worth only 1 point. You would give him 2, to be fair. But he obviously got Niva out of rhythm. And Koki Niva from Japan now finds himself in a troublesome situation. Had 5-1 and lost 5 points in a row, but scores there, so 6-all. Now he's obviously with the serve. But the tactical sense also is a question mark for Niva. He scores a lot of different points on various kinds of shots, but needs now to dig deep and show good sense, good care in the game, not lifting out balls like that. Which is not really the perfect technique or execution. Better touch on that when you step into the ball, and which needs to come up with a lot more body support for his forehand technique. Place that one, though, and Niva caught a little bit with the length of that serve, so let's see if we can keep this one short. Good opportunity, but Robineau hesitating a little bit in the movement and the footwork, and both those points played out of position. And the backhand service return was too short and gave Niva too much time. A much better by Niva in the finishing stages of that third game. He needed that, and now he's only down 1 instead of 3, which is a huge difference. So he kept himself in this match and started to play quite a lot better from 7-all in the third. So positive for Japan, positive for Koki Niva, that now is down 1-2 in the semifinal, and we'll be back shortly.
again. Another night of show. Bravo. One love.
Let's see now in the fourth game. Obviously, Niva more confident, perhaps. Confidence is such a good factor, obviously, in all table tennis situations or competitions, but especially on the junior side, where it can change go back and forth in a match like this, no problem. That's what table tennis will bring to you. A lot of excitement, fantastic shot making, and extreme skill. But the consistency is always a question mark and changes also rapidly in the matches. Momentum is a big thing in junior table tennis. We're showing here 3-1, and some confident serves. This is sometimes the problem for Robin Orr, that he loses some of his good rhythm and then starting to take a lot more risks. Now this one was let, so Robin Orr has another chance. Topspin, and Robin Orr is very strong from distance. When he gets time to execute his technique, it's very powerful. A lot of topspin in his both back and forehand is coordinating well between the two. Perhaps in his serve. Almost good though, the length in that serve, so Robin Orr couldn't attack really with his backhand, but so to try to push it short back, but did a mistake. Fantastic form again, a few mistakes before that, but if you can finish off points like that, then you are a good player, and Robin Orr clearly showing that he's taken a huge step just lately. Just the last few months, and of course a win against Malin at the Pro 2 level is such a confidence builder. He didn't play fantastically well actually in the team competition here, but he showed in the singles a completely different player. Robin Orr has been playing very well all through the singles competition, and is also part of the double finals where Simon Gossi and Robin Orr will take on the Chinese pair in the junior boys final. And that should be a good chance to actually win a gold medal. This is the 9th World Junior Championships, and so far actually it's been tremendously dominated by the Asian continent, and Europe winning only one gold medal during these 9 years. But it is Robin Orr playing very, very strong table tennis, and Niva seems to be lacking some kind of direction and tactics for the moment, which is another problem that he often displays. Scoring a lot of different ways is good, but you have to put it in play and have strategy in play and follow that. So now, obviously, a good timeout from Koki Niva and his coach to discuss tactics. Niva is one of these players that always seems to be have an ability to come back and play well and also stay in the matches. So I would be surprised if this will be a runaway victory for any of these players. good serve. Side over spin. Robin Aarhus misjudged the spin in the ball. So Niva with another serve. Gets the ball up. But then again, one of these errors from Koki Niva. And now Robin Aarhus obviously in a very, very good situation with the serve. Should be able to split. Perhaps. That's at least what he's thinking, but that one was well played by Niva with a lot of spin in his forehand topspin. Let's see Robin Aarhus now. Maybe it's a too easy placement, just went at cross court. They played perhaps the ball against the new team, but decided to go that one is. Fairly a lot of time for Robin Aarhus to work that one against Middle perhaps, but then went cross and Niva back into this game. Locking out, good spin. Robin Aarhus going fast backhand. Good shot, and that's amazing by Koki Niva. That's really, you know, one of these shots that. Let's see what happens here. Really. 10-all, Quentin Robin Aarhus. Hesitated a little bit on the side, wasn't not too confident in that situation, so Niva now suddenly finds himself with a game point. And then used that down the line direction on the serve that he scored so many direct points on so far, 4 or 5, and there's some fun times in the Japanese corners, and why not? You have to be happy when you play good table tennis, and that's what he's doing now. Coming back in this match, losing the two opening games, and now winning 11-7, 12-10 in dramatic fashion. To level this match as 2-2. So now Niva definitely back into it. Been in serious trouble, I would say, but also now getting the flow back into his game, and Robin Aarhus is starting to think seriously about this now. And both players are really not wasting any time at all. It's just quality serve and then very, very quick decisions and opening up to each other, not afraid of playing really also on the racket. It could be a tactical sense, it's really important, but point scoring and shot making, both days are really showing good skills. Safer shots. You need to change a little bit of the rhythm. It cannot just challenge all the time. Niva's made quite a lot of errors, I think, but may find himself in a more confident position and then put those on the table and you're in trouble. Robin Aarhus down 2 points. challenging again and again, and now it's time for to find a bit of another rhythm on the first two, but again along fast. So I was obviously reading that Milos walking over to take backhand short in forehand, and then you come down the line, which is fairly effective here. And you need to have that option obviously open in your serves because of the fact that a lot of players now are working in by their backhand so deep into the table, so you need to use that to serve quite often. And that was a good attack by Nemo, found the pocket of Robineau. Careless Robineau there, using it long fast again. Fantastic scoring from that perfect distance for Quentin. Staying there and working hard to play that one down the line. Hard to read his attacks. He can go all over the table. Six, eight. Let's see if Robineau can serve a little bit with better care or quality. That fits his game very well. Side over spin, the ball out, and then you work from the distance. I understand that. And then now we will serve again. Heavy pressure on. Nemo once again standing a little bit still in his forehand game, doesn't find the right distance, too close, and just taking a risk. Good rally, Koki Nemo at his very best. Both blocking close table, also working out, and that round forehand there was the finisher on that excellent rally, 9-8, Koki Nemo. Another one of these unforced errors, has been at least 5-6 of those. So if I were Quentin Robineau here, I would better take this game. And go 3-2 up. If I were on the short, sorry. Advancing to the final. But he missed just that one and played it net out. Serve I like, more confident, slower, a little bit of underspin, change the pace in the serve and change the spin in the serve. Well played by Robineau, has got a good ball to work at and scored the point. Yeah! What an angle on that forehand top spin. We pulled that deep, deep into Robineau's back, and although he was there, he couldn't do anything. And the ball flew off the table and out of the court, and you have to go and pick it up and then give it to Robineau. Now let's see if Quentin can do something with the serve. Again, and that was long, Koki. You had to top spin on that one, but he was there early with his racket, just put the racket on the ball. Moved well, Koki, to use his forehand again after service. And good serve again, my Quentin Robineau, But Nivan returning not with the perfect touch. He was missing two serves in a row, and that one, yeah, he's not happy with that one. I'm sure Koki would now with the serve. Quick service and just executing also close table. So, and we again, fourth game point. And Obino reading the attack. Perfect. Knew it was coming across table. Diagonal forearm by Nila. That was a good service return by Robinho. He got that one perfectly length, and he has had a stretch on that ball. It was not too deep, but a lot of spin. And that's perfectly executed by Quentin Robinho, and really put a short ball back, and that's what you have to do. You cannot only open up all the time and challenging. The other player is good size, here tactically well played by Quentin, good relaxed technique. And actually Quentin Robinho now leading 3-2 against the favorite in this match, Koki Niva. I'm sure Jack Bobesan here finds his player doing very well so far. They have great connection, coach player in France, and that's Quentin shown also that extra maturity that will help him when he's now leaving the junior age of table tennis, 18 and under, and advancing to much bigger competitions and more important thing obviously in his professional life. For Robinho to start well here. Many, many times scoring point with that heavy, heavy spin against Nivas forearm, and he's just making errors after errors if you put pressure on his forearm side. And Robinho knows that, of course. Perfect backhand. Really right into the body of Niva. And excellent start, Quentin Robinho leading 3-2, 2-0. Good service return as well, but Nina pushed the ball deep into Robinho's backhand and couldn't get his technique in order. Fantastic save by Robinho from far off the table. And put extra spin in that one, and Niva really couldn't do anything, he just misjudged it completely. Doesn't miss too many rows, Robinho, but now could overplay that back and just a little bit. Best of serves. Niva came in right away, was dominating in that rally. A bit of a missed opportunity for Quentin to open up a gap here in the crucial six game. Perhaps thinking about it, junior table tennis, don't watch the scoreboard, keep playing one point at a time. Obviously drifting away a little bit with his concentration. Missing a few easy points, came back there. Very well. Needs to take a deep breath and think about it now in terms of service. Milos ready for that short ball back and attack it over the table. A lot of spin in that attack though, and really the kind of placement and possibilities to go around corner and work with his forehand has been successful for Robinho so far. And now Mingal reading and putting the good service on the table, and Robin also didn't get a good touch on that one, although it was well played. Iba played even better, knew where the ball was coming and moved away, and then used his forearm. Patience by Quentin, very well. Took off some of the speed on the opening shot and then went cross table, very tough. But he was also working on Robinho's service, and Robinho's maybe serving a little bit weaker from a quality standpoint right now. Too easy to see the direction, Niva right there with his backhand. Quickly used his footwork, came back into that one, saved an important point. Quentin Robinho now only 2 points from advancing to the final. Let's see if Niva has any answers now. It's a question of quality of serve, I think. And he had his chances there, Quentin. Good opening shot, good block by Niva, but then hesitating just a little bit on that particular point there. He misjudged a little bit, lost some of his balance and footwork. Niva with the serve, obviously an advantage in this case. It's been fairly consistent, scoring at least one in his own service, but that's very well played, well read by Quentin, that has now actually a match point. And that went quickly away. Quentin now has to regroup. Some drama again. One hit almost the edge of the racket and also the edge of the table. And Niva's from Quentin showing some really survivor skills here. And sigh of relief there. He was in trouble but came back now again with the serve. It's all about the quality now in his service. Yeah, that one was part of the plan obviously, but Niva's really been reading that one perfectly the last 2 times, and it's just one of those decision making situations where young players have to learn now. Niva. Scoring that one, and we have, not surprisingly in this match as it went back and forth all the way, we have Koki Niva saving one match point and taking then the sixth game, and we have a 3-3 situation in this Volkswagen World Junior Table Tennis Championships. High drama, first semifinal in the Junior Boys single between Koki Niwa, Japan, and Quentin Robineau from France. Both players back at the table with Niwa to serve. Start obviously important, but just to keep yourself in the game, the critical point. Some hesitation in that service return for Robineau, an easy point for Niwa. So much better for Koki when he steps into the ball in his forehand and just standing on the same staggered position. They're really working over the table and scoring. Different, just waving with his arm a bit. Difficult shot. Obviously the spin has something to do with that as well. Robineau is good on those balls there. Spin is hard to handle for Niwa, but he's taking also a lot of risk in his forehand games. Well placed first attack by Robineau, but Niwa answered back, and then Robineau tried to go down the line, just lifted the ball out. And Jacques Momissan doesn't like the start really that much. Remember also that Niwa did a few unforced error hairs, and Jacques Momissan obviously caught that as well, knows that, you know, probably Niwa will put some of these on the table in the future. So he realizes that Quentin needs a break. The whole point now is to keep your cool and be patient. Do not take find a fine balance of risk taking and safety in your game. And also tactical sense will play a difference here in the end, how these young players will be able to execute that. And I would say mix of spectators and participants finding their way to this beautiful Bahrain Table Tennis Center in Isatown, Manama, where we all had such a good time this week. Ball by Quentin, who really needs to just hang in there now. Seems like he's hesitating just a little bit. Had one game point, match point also, remember that. And saved that one miraculously. Just putting a lot of spin in that ball, misjudged it a little bit, an unbelievable spin. And Eva just again an unforced forehand error. Quick back and attack by Robineau from France. Was fought back, scored 3 points in a row here, very important, obviously. And a bit of luck, and he finds himself now with a 7-5 lead, Niva to serve. I remember the match point also in the 6-3-4-2, but now obviously a very, very tight match. Five of the six games going above 10, which means 2 points difference only. And we have 7-all. Unbelievable match. Played on a very, very high level. Now 8-7, feeling it. Such an important part of the game now to keep yourself cool and composed. But these are young players, so you see a lot of those kind of shots. And again, a fantastic backhand by Korki Niva. He just moved over and got the racket on the ball there and pulled it cross table out of reach for Quentin Robineau. Okay, losing a little bit of his balance, footwork. Hooking in at 9-8. Drama here in Manama, for sure. Fantastic semifinal. We have 9-all. What an exciting match, and really the teammates supporting heavily. Some nerves among the assistant coaches and players, obviously. Wishing the last year union Quentin Robineau some success here. Let's see. Offside overspin, and Korki read that perfectly. Now has his first match point. The Japanese supporters are happy. And such a crucial thing now, what kind of serve to put on the table has been very... And there's Korki Niva through to the final. And it's a disappointment for Quentin Robineau, that had one match point in game number 6. Also was leading 7-5 here, and what a match. Robineau played that one very well, he just lifted that ball out, I'm sure very, very, very disappointed leaving the court. Played a strong match for sure. Korki Niva is one of these survivors that sometimes will really give you some fantastic shot making capabilities mixed up with unforced errors, and also at times also a lack of tactical discipline, I would say. But it's a fantastic player. Korki Niva is through to the finals later this afternoon, and we are awaiting the second semi-final here in Manama, Bahrain, in the Uniboy single, and we'll take a short break.